Well, good day, friends, and welcome back to the St. Paul Handicapable Ministries YouTube service. Can you realize that we're now entering the month of May? All right, we've got a lot on our schedule today, so let's look and see what we're going to be doing. Well, we're going to be singing some of our songs. Okay, Jesse, take us away with the songs we're going to be singing today. Sing along. I know you know them.
Oh, birthday. Anybody got a birthday? Maybe you've already had one. You got one coming up before next week. Oh, we got a birthday. Come, birthday. Look, you got a birthday. Come on up here. All right, big hand. All right, we're going to sing happy birthday now, okay? You're so beautiful tonight. We love you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Wasn't that fantastic? Happy birthday. You're the most beautiful birthday girl of the day. Beautiful. Thank you. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Okay. That's wonderful. Great. Okay. We got the joy song. Renee can, let's see. Can you help gather up a few people to help take the offering up? Maybe Ola's back there. Maybe Ola could do that. There we go. We'll get a few that are going on. Denise, here are the baskets up here. We love to sing the joy song. We love to give praise and thanksgiving to God for this wonderful ministry. Okay, you ready? I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay. I've got the light of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the light of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. I've got the peace of Jesus down in my heart. Down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the peace of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart to say. Would you give that to Ola? I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay. All right, way to go. Oh, handy announcement. Gail wants us to remember that God loves us all the time, and primarily just on Wednesday nights. Every day? Every second? Every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every week of every month of every year. He loves us throughout eternity, and I pray I've made myself quite clear. Woohoo! We are so thankful.
All right, anybody in here happy?
I see two people out there that are happy, Renee. All right, let's try to get in a happy mood. You ready? If you're happy and you know it, now clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, now clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, now clap your hand. Now, if you're happy and you know it, snap your fingers. If you're happy and you know it, now snap your fingers. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, snap your fingers. Now, if you're happy and you know it, slap your knees. If you're happy and you know it, now slap your knees. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, now slap on your knees. Now if you're happy and you know it, now stomp your feet, stomp, stomp. If you're happy and you know it, now stomp your feet, stomp, stomp. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, now stomp with your feet. Now if you're happy and you know it, now touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, now touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, now touch it, you know. Now if you're happy and you know it, pull on your right ear. If you're happy and you know it, pull on your left ear. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, pull on your both. Now if you're happy and you know it, now say amen. Amen. If you're happy and you know it, now whisper amen. Amen. If you're happy and you know it, then your face should surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, now shout amen. Woo-hoo! Way to go, team. Way to sing, sing, sing.
One of the things that we're real excited about is a new adventure that we're on. We're trying to go back and create individual and group home and just groups of people with spotlights. And we started our program with that. And all total, I think we're going to have at least 49. So we're going to feature several of them as we go along, not only on YouTube like we're going to do tonight, but also we're going to be doing those when we meet in person. All right, let's see who we've got on the schedule for tonight. Sit back and enjoy.
Tonight, we're taking a journey back to Wednesday evening, June the 25th, 2014, when 161 strong of the St. Paul Handicapable Ministry honored fellow member Andrea Spencerio for having won 2 gold medals and 2 ribbons at the recently held National Special Olympics in Newark, New Jersey. Andrea's gold medals were for the 400 and 800 meter walks. She won a ribbon for 4th place in the shot put and 1 for 6th place in the 4x100 meter relay. Maria Sauter, one of Andrea's Special Olympics coaches, did the honor of placing the medals and ribbons on Andrea. Andrea had us in stitches as she told her many funny stories of what it is like to be at a National Olympics for a full week. What an inspiring story to hear and to see firsthand how this ministry of God's special people is making such a positive influence in the lives of members of our Handy family. Andrea, we are so proud of you. Thank you for playing a key role in our lesson Wednesday evening, being the best one can be. What a wonderful example you have set for us all. Certainly, this was an evening in which Jesus smiled down upon these precious ones. Now, let's review Andrea's singing talents at our 23rd talent show. Janet, along with her mother Vicki and sisters Andrea and Ashley, have been a part of our ministry for 25 years. All are so talented and have been so instrumental in taking Handicapable to new heights. Just a few of Janet's talents include crafts, caroling, Special Olympics, being a colorful character, being an outstanding artist, being a hug ambassador, dancing, at our Handicapable parties. Wearing outstanding costumes. And participating at Handicapable's fabulous Christmas parties. All right, Janet, please share your latest dance moves at our recently held 24th annual talent show. Here you go. Janet, we appreciate you so much and are so thankful for all you do to help keep our ministry strong. God bless you.
Well, I hope that you enjoy those. It's a real pleasure to work on that. And a great deal of gratitude to Laurel, who's been working to upload those to YouTube. Thank you so much, Laurel, for your faithfulness and being able to help us complete our project. Jesus has promised to it, one of our gold nuggets from Matthew 28:20, when Jesus was ascending back into heaven, he says, "And surely I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Isn't that comforting to know? As we go to our prayer time, we want to continue to pray for all of us as we continue on into 2023. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we're thankful for the start of another one of these wonderful services we have on YouTube. How we've been blessed, O Father, for now over 2.5 years that we've been doing this and being able to provide an opportunity for those who are at home to watch worship services through the YouTube. Bless us in all that we do. Thank you for this wonderful church. And be with us as we have our service tonight. I ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. All righty, we're going to start on some new series tonight. We're going to be talking about Jesus ascends to heaven. We're going to be looking at the book of Acts, and we're going to start with Acts 1, verses 9 through 11, and this is what was written there. "Now when Jesus had spoken these things while they watched, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight." Now let's review just very quickly about where Jesus had been. You know, Jesus had been crucified. He was resurrection. And while he had been resurrected, he was here on earth for 40 days and had been making special appearances to disciples and to others. And now it's coming time where he was going to go back and be a part of the heavenly scene. Now, one of the things we need to keep in mind is that we're going to be looking at the glory of the departure. You know, Jesus had been here. He left his messages for all. And then also we'll be looking and also what is going to be left for the disciples to do to continue on with his church and everything. And so while the disciples were there, they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up. "Behold, two men who were angels stood by them in white apparel, who also said, 'Men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven.'" Two or three things I want to point out here. One, there's been a great deal of speculation about when Jesus will return again. And even Jesus told his disciples, "Listen, I do not know the day and I do not know the hour." So none of us should speculate as to when we think that day may come, but we do need to prepare ourselves so when that day comes, and if we're still here, then we can meet Jesus when he returns again. Also, one of the things we're going to learn as we continue with our lesson series this day, we're going to be looking at different ways that Jesus calls upon us to be leaders and make the church grow. How is the church going to grow? Disciples went back. They were filled with great joy in the fact that they knew that Jesus one time had told them he would promise that he would return again. And as we go forward in our series study, we'll be looking at some of the things the disciples had to do to prepare for that particular day. All righty. What do we need to do to follow Jesus and become followers of Him? We need to follow Jesus. We need to read, believe, and act on His Word. And we need to pray for strength and guidance. If we do those three things, we know we're well on the road to being able to one day cross over that threshold and have Jesus welcome into heaven. All right, I hope you've enjoyed the service tonight. Be sure and be with us next week. For those of you who are able, we'd love to have you attend in person every Wednesday, 6:30, here at St. Paul United Methodist Church in Largo. God bless you all.